All right, break that fucking Sarah gun. I dare you, dog. I'm gonna one by one. All right.
Let's see.
Do you have any partner items I should try to stack?
This should be good. I have an idea right here.
Shorty like a $1,000 plate, fine china. Tell her that she beautiful every day, I remind her. And I jump in a pussy like a lake, I'm a diver. And the last man was a pussy had a vagina. Yo, what is up, boys? Welcome back to a brand new video on Viper MC on the Inferno Realm. Today's video is going to be a brand new series on my channel, and it's going to be How I HCF. I'm sure you guys have seen this on Heyfu's channel before, but it's basically going to be just me, like, running a base and stuff, explaining how I play the game, and, you know, overall it's going to be a fun series. It's going to be different from How to HCF, so I'm not going to be, like, I'm still going to be taking donations from my friends, and I'm still going to be, like, you know, doing my kits and stuff. It's just going to be me explaining basically what I'm doing, what my mindset is in bases and stuff, because I know a lot of people have been asking me how I run in bases and stuff, and like some ways to get better at the game. So yeah, that's pretty much what the series is going to be. And before the video starts, I do want to thank you guys again for 200 subscribers. It does mean a lot to me. Let's try to hit 15 likes this video. That would mean a lot to me. And yeah, with that all being said, I hope you guys have a great day and enjoy the video. Alright boys, we just got to the base and Tango did let me have his partner packages, but sadly he had to go for the rest of the start of the world, so I'm gonna go ahead and open these really quickly. And in case you guys didn't know, I am doing How I HCF this map. It's not gonna be How to HCF, but it's gonna be like me basically just explaining how I get set up and everything, so there's just gonna be a lot more clips, like update clips and you guys seeing how I play the game and stuff, and me explaining more stuff and bases in case I didn't make that clear in like the intro and stuff. But yeah, so first partner package, we got some Trap Stars, some Bird Getaway Sugars, Tank Ingots, Lucky Ingots, and Patriarch's Prepearls. And I don't know if you guys knew this or not, but they actually did like a really big buff to the Patriarch's Prepearls, where it doesn't put you in CD anymore, and it'll tell you if, like, it'll tell you whenever you have 3 seconds left before you TP. So that's going to be really nice, because as you guys know, these are my favorite partner item in the game. And yeah, overall, I'm really happy with this, so I'm gonna go ahead and go get some sand, wood, and since no one else in my faction is able to play, I might just have to do everything by myself. Or actually, before I go get sand and wood, I kinda wanna, I wanna go open up these 2.0 keys real quick, so let me go ahead and pop my reclaim, just so I can get my lives, and then they also did something called block shop, so we can literally buy like blocks and stuff now, which is kind of sick. What I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna run to spawn real quick and open up these keys, and I'll bring you guys back whenever I get there. Oh my god, dude, why is this so loud? Okay, I'm gonna just turn my sounds off for now. So I did just get to spawn. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm probably gonna sell all my dude, where the heck are the bells? Okay, I'm just gonna sell all of these really fast. And I don't know if I showed this off, but they do have like a new block shop command, so you can type /block shop and you can just like buy anything. So what I might do is I might buy some wool, make a nice base with that, or some sand clay. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and buy a few blaze rods, just a little bit of this. So let's spam buy this. We don't really need these, so I'm gonna go ahead and toss out whatever we don't need. Let's just buy a little bit of these, buy some more of these, buy some golden carrots so we can brew invis, buy some slime balls. And oh crap, boys, I just realized. Okay, I'll buy some gas here also. Might as well. I just realized I'm gonna need space for my fucking 2.0 keys, so I might go ahead and just clear up these pickaxes really quickly. And then maybe throw out like a stack of. Okay, so I'm gonna do really fast. I'm gonna go open up the 2.0 keys now. So, first 2.0 key, we got. Dude, that is literally legendary. That is like the best thing I could have gotten, to be honest. Okay, so I'm gonna throw out some of these really fast. That shouldn't be too big of a deal, to be honest. I'll throw the sugar too, because okay. And then dude, what, wait, that is so good, bro. That is literally so good. We just got 3 sacks of snowballs and 8 aggressive pearls. That's gonna be so big, guys. Okay, so Divine's on right now, but he's just kind of AFKing, so I might literally just have to do every single thing by myself for start of the world until like my faction actually gets back. So I think I'm gonna buy some cow eggs really quickly, and then just a few ink stacks. Okay, so I'm gonna go at home, boys. I don't know if I showed you guys a claim yet, but
Here it is. It's not exactly first claim. It's like 150 away from first claim. But it's like 30 by 30 with a 20 by 17 extension. So it's not too bad at all. No, it's this whole area right here. So we should be able to build a nice base with it. I think I'm going to flatten out my claim with my neighbors. And then, yeah, we'll just go from there. So I'll bring you boys back. Alright boys, quick little update on the base. I decided to make like a little upside down snowman break dancing. I don't know why, but I had the opportunity to, so I was like, you know, why not, let's make a upside down break dancing snowman. And we got Spino's head and the base verified by Spino, the man himself. So we have Caleb and N right now farming pearls, and we have Divine over in Nether getting glowstone, and I'll probably farm GP at like the last 5 to 10 minutes left to start of the world. So I'm bringing us back.
Alright boys, so I'm back to F-list the people. So F who Fliss, that's the guy who I just ran into. So he honestly wasn't that good at blocking up. I accidentally just slipped down his like drop down. And as you guys can see, still F focused for some reason. So I might as well go ahead and run back there. I don't know, I'm pretty confident that I can make him raidable. I might shift halfway in, because he said he was low on pots earlier. Let me actually message him right now how many pots you have, so I can just see if he's capping or not. 10 pots, he says, okay. Let's go. We've had a bone right now. I know for a fact that I can make him raidable if he really doesn't. Or if he's really not lying about having 10 pots. So I guess my best option would honestly be, I don't want to go down the drop down no matter what, because from past experience, the drop down just leads to him getting into the base, going back up deep sign, then him blocking up again like pretty fast, because I can't really stick that whenever he's like up a second before me. So what I might do is, if he does follow down the, or if he does jump down the drop down, I might stay up top, wait for him to come back up, try to Bambi web wherever his F home is or up sign is, and then just try to brick wall from basically doing anything. So that should be the plan here. And let's see, man. Wait, I can't snowball him, can I? No, dog, I was about to say that would have been so funny. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and do this so I can't really tell where I am if I'm in the base. I want to get my partner items out, as always, put these in the middle, put that like that, shift halfway in. I think I'm going to shift halfway in just for this one. Just check it. Yeah, nice cap. Whatever, duck. I'll just run in, screw it, duck. Just go for it. I got mining fatigue and weakness, that is pretty unfortunate, but whatever, dude. So I might just, let's see. He's definitely not blocking this up by just sticking his body right here, man. Quick drop it here. No way, right? Oh, dude, he was super low. Dog, I can tell he's just super low right there. So he can't do anything here. You always want to get them in position like this, because then they're stuck. Oh, wait. Dude, if he didn't have a grip block, I swear to God, that would have been so nice. I just need a way from having have a crit blocker. That's honestly whenever I get into the 1v1 with him. Oh shit, dude. This guy knows he's too smart for me, man. Jesus Christ, man. Alright, lad. I'm not liking this so far. Oh wait, I can do snowball right here. Alright, dude. Alright, break that in. Alright, I'm with him. Alright, so anytime they want to break a bottom block, you always want to try to hit a tally pearl into it with them. So what I just have to do now is stick back and forth inside of his body. Right? Oh, I just lagged. I literally had a lag spike. Are you serious right now? Alright, what I might do here is Patriarch pre-pearl right here. And then he should get cocky enough. Oh fuck yes, baby. He should get cocky enough to try to make a play here. And then, alright, I think it's gonna lead me to the block. Shit, bro, alright. And then I can snowball him. But I know for a fact he's gonna let me draw. Alright, dude. My med dog, please. Albert, please help me. Alright, man, he really does not want to help me right here. There's really no point in trying to scum him right here. Alright, can I draw? Alright, I'm just gonna hope he doesn't try to scum me right here. I know I'm gonna outping him right here, so what I can realistically just do is do like this. Alright. Alright, then I'm in with him. I know I'm gonna outping him right there. Alright, bro. Anytime you're outpinging something like that, you always wanna try to scum them. That's literally so ideal. Alright, he's got strength 2 or rest 3 for some long time right here. Alright, he's dead here. If he doesn't pot, he would have died right there. See, I really have to stick him right here. He's gonna fucking split me up. Shit, bug. It's just... Alright, man. Oh, he's actually an idiot, dog. He's actually an idiot, dude. He's so retarded. Alright. Wait, this guy's really stupid. Alright, I can just pearl into this block. Alright, hear me out, boys. Just hear me out for a second. Alright, break that fucking stair again, I dare you, dog. I'm gonna 1v1 him. Alright. It's fucking beautiful, boss. I really need this shit so bad. Okay, just give me a second. Let's get this out. Give me literally 1 second, and I should be able to acro pearl right here. I'm gonna pop the full. I'm gonna wait till we're gonna clear up battle real quickly. Alright, come on, dribble. Alright. Alright, let's take literally anything that I can get really fast. Shit. Please don't, like, steal everything instantly, bro. Alright, I don't think this guy really had much, to be honest with you guys. That's, like I said, something you always wanna do whenever that you know for a fact that you're gonna be able to outping them in a situation like that. You always want to go for a scum. Like, don't feel bad, bro. Like, literally do not feel bad. It's HCF, dog. Do what you gotta do to make someone raidable, and then no remorse. That's basically it. And there's Caleb moaning in the call. I don't know why, but he fell asleep and now he's moaning in his sleep for like past 30 minutes. But yeah, like I said, if you're outpinging someone like you saw was there, and I also did that to Stefan, how I was significantly outpinging him, then if they really aren't gonna scum you, then they'll try to mine you out or something, and along the lines of that, and you can just snowball them, or you can pop on your side and pearl in with them like I did. And another thing you could do is you always want to make it as difficult as possible for them to grind you like I did there, because then he was starting to get nervous and he tried to mine me into an area so I couldn't F home, right? And then I was able to just snowball pearl into a 1v1 with him. And another thing I suggest is don't be scared to pearl. Like, that's the only way you're gonna get better, is if you take those risky pearls, and obviously you're gonna die sometimes, but other times you'll learn how to like perfectly time those pearls and how to perfectly land them, and it always takes a lot of practice and learning, like learning the patterns of the pearls and stuff on the server. So that's something I would suggest. That's something I do a lot, is I literally just take the dumbest pearls sometimes, because yeah, you just gotta learn from experience and stuff. So that is one big thing I suggest. So yeah, I'll bring you guys back in another base raid. Something I should explain real quick is how I choose what loadout to bring. You always want to bring, if you have like over 2 stacks of snowballs, you always want to try to bring at least 2 to 3 snowballs whenever you're in a base, because those are helpful. You always want to bring a Patrox pre-pearl, and something I suggest with Patrox pre-pearl is if you know the guy's already good with that blocking up and stuff in like whatever kind of base, it's especially good in 2 highs. But if you're in like a 3x1 or a 4x1 or something like that with like a little curved area like this, then you're always going to want to Patrox pre-pearl in one corner, go to the opposite corner, wait for him to block it off, wait until you see like an open egg entrance and then message him drop. And whenever he does try to let you drop something, that's whenever you can either one, just like start dropping pots or something and wait it out, or you can two, do what I did in a few clips where I just snowballed and got into a 1x1 and then got in with him. So I am seeing a lot of people advertising in chat right now. 1D0, I not splash. Okay, if you guys really want to get good at base raiding, then I recommend you guys just keep on practicing. Practice on kit map, practice on HCF. Learn what the most comfortable clicking method is for you. I know whenever I used to run to bases, I could jitter click, and sometimes I'll lose control of my aim. But I found with butterfly clicking, just butterfly clicking, is really not that hard to like aim your mouse and stuff. So just find like stuff like that. Like it's just a lot of testing out and stuff, and just learning what works best. So like I said, just make sure you guys do like run in bases, and don't be scared. Like if you see a 3 height base, it's only a 1DTR, you know, just like go for it. Like if you die, you die. Unless you have no sets, and you probably don't want to do that, but you know, it's not a big deal if you die and you have like 5 sets left. Because then you have opportunity to 1DTR trap or just run to another base. Like don't be scared to run to bases, guys. It's literally the only way you're gonna learn. So with that being said, I'm at this guy's base, so I'm gonna go ahead and get my strength 2 items out, do this, get my Patrox pre-pro out. And something I do like to do in base sometimes, instead of getting a Patrox pre-pro out, is getting one of these out. And I know for a fact this guy's got some sketch ass trap right here, bro. I'm calling it, bro. Oh wait, never mind, he doesn't. Okay, strength 2 for 7 seconds. So whenever I'm in 2 highs, I'm literally just like sticking wide. I like sticking like right in their bodies. Like you never want to give them a wide angle to work with, or that's whenever you're probably going to get screwed up. Okay, so I'm going to Bambi webgun him so that restricts where he can move. Because once you Bambi webgun, then he's going to have a much harder time placing blocks in certain areas. So now I can get my aggressive pearl out, and I just waste an aggressive pearl. Alright, well that guy's raidable. That is pretty funny. Alright bro, let me just go check out this guy's base. Is this his whole fucking base, dog? I can't believe I just wasted an aggressive pearl like the last second, bro. Alright. Like I said, Bambi webguns help a lot in bases. Whenever you're Bambi webgunning, I recommend you back up like I did there. Like whenever they're panicking or like in their inventory, you can noticeably tell if they're in their inventory and they're not focused on blocking you up. I recommend you back up and try to Bambi webgun on open area blocks, like the biggest section that would have potential blocking up in, because then that restricts them from going there as well as placing blocks there, which will cause them to be even more like panic even more, and he's more prone to quick dropping if you get him in a spot like that, like you guys just saw he did there. So let me go ahead and pearl up really quickly. But GG's to this guy. I'm gonna go ahead and F home and start filling another faction really fast.
Alright boys, I'm gonna start F listing people right now. We're just looking for people who are advertising chats. I'm gonna F list 17. Let's see. One guy, that's one guy. Okay. Great. I think I made the guy raidable before. So another thing I like doing while I'm F listing people is looking for people I've made raidable before. So
168, 1223.
Oh wait, he literally was right next to us.
Yeah. But your voice just got a hell of a lot deeper.
Oh hold up.
Yo.
Alright, there you go. Is it better?
Yeah, what happened?
My mic gets weird sometimes. I have to replug it.
Oh, dude, this guy.
Just run in.
Oh, okay, yeah. But he can block up super easy, just remember.
That's what I'm saying, bro. This is literally AIDS. Should I bro Invis and like go check out, like go sit his drop down and stuff really quick?
No, I say we come back later.
Nah.
Because obviously. Can I gank this Bardo?
No, I think we should just go for it, bro.
Really? Do we have sets to die? Because it's like it's a death sentence almost.
We have sets. Just get him to open the gates. Don't shift halfway. So I'm gonna give him to back up. Alright, bro.
Don't pearl it.
I'm in. Oh no, I'm not.
Okay. I'm not. I'm in. Are you?
Alright, try to get him to go down his drop down. Try to get him to go down
his drop down. He's not going down his drop down, bro.
Really?
Alright. I snowballed him out, though. Right. No way, I just risked. Oh, I'm back up.
Dude, if he goes down his drop down, he's already dead right here. Oh, wait, can I get him with him? I want him. I got mining particular weakness, but whatever.
Go down. No.
Alright, bro, this is Miss. This is drop down, dog.
His upside might take
I literally don't get why anyone would have. Oh my god, wait, if you get out, you can lever me in.
Okay.
Bro, if you can get out, you can lever me in.
I can't get out. I'm gonna F stuck.
Alright, nice, bro. You can just lever me in literally right now so easily.
Yep. Pop a kit starter.
Alright, Don, you need
me. Oh, I just fell down. Fuck. Jesus. Heads up.
Dog. My pearl just went through the ceiling, bro. Nah, I'm dead because my pearl just went through the ceiling. Are you fucking shitting me right now? Game slot, I can't have you in here, bro.
I know. F stuck. You can F home, right?
Alright.
Can you F home?
Yeah.
F home and lever me in. Or no, because you want the clip.
There's no point. Like, he blocked it all off where you could lever in.
So bad.
He's gonna think I'm out, though.
Yeah, he's gonna mine over there.
This cunt, bro. Try to snowball him in.
Oh my gosh, he just blocked that off. Okay. Well, he blocked it off. I literally can't, though.
Alright. Alright, I need him to stop looking at me so I can fucking pay charge creeper. Alright, charge creeper. Oh. I was pre-pearled. Bro.
Oh, pre-pearl's not gonna do anything.
Bro.
Oh, I'm stuck in. Should I get out?
If you really want, bro.
Oh, I'm trying to cancel it.
Bro, I could just snowball him in.
I stuck out. Okay, I'm out. I can snowball him if you need.
Oh, wait. If you're out, lever him. Lever me in. Lever me in this area.
Alright, I need to find the base. Where is it? Course. Oh my gosh, it spawned me far.
It's actually really close, dog.
Yeah, I know, but it's
come
spawned
fucking,
me far.
Come bard. Come fucking bard, please.
Hold on, I'm here.
Come bard. It's okay, come
bard.
Do
you want me to lever you or no?
I don't know. Realistically, okay,
I'm
no.
In my kit starter.
Nah, just don't.
Just in case.
Don't. Just come bard, bro. Come bard, please.
Alright.
If you're in bard, this kid is gonna be so screwed.
Okay, let me F him.
Like he's literally vibing right now, just because I don't have a bard.
Okay.
He's gonna break this right. Alright. I'm really dead now. I'm in with him. No, I'm not.
Is that all you need?
Yeah, realistically, just come as fast as you fucking
can. That's how you're getting. Hopefully, no one ganks me.
Come with jump boost, too.
Oh my dude, I literally just pearled to the base. Come on now. You have strength.
I'm res, alright, that's fine. Yeah, I don't think he's grinding me, actually. Yeah, I don't know if I can either jump boost. He's not grinding me regardless. Wait, realistically, dog, if he blocks off right here, I can just cross pearl. This guy's having mad difficulties grinding me right now. Alright, bro, if he breaks this again, I'm gonna snowball him in. Can you shrink to me?
Yeah, when you want it.
Alright, I'll tell you when. He's gonna choke right here. I'm fucking calling this.
It's two. I'm literally watching.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna snowball him right here, bro. Dog, I'm in a space.
Yeah, no, you can pearl up to the top base too. There's a hole.
Tell me if I should.
No, you shouldn't. I mean, I think you're good where you are. Better spot right there.
Yeah, honestly, this is really good right here. Bro, I feel like he's gonna choke and I'm gonna get in with him. I'm about to fucking Kobe this pearl. About to snipe his ass with this shit, dog. I swear to God. Wait, just give me a second, dog. We'll have a pearl inside the chest right here. Now I'm in the same level with him. Alright, bro, I'm literally on the same level now, so if he fucking breaks, I can snowball him. I'll pearl in. Dog, I just... I'm fucking stuck, bro. I can't move. Me so easily, bro. Alright, dog. No, I need to fucking be off CD for this, man. Alright, man. I'm dead right here. I think he just got me.
No, you can pearl up. Oh, not anymore. He just blocked it.
Let's see.
Do you have any partner items I should try to stack?
This should be good. I have an idea right here. Oh my god, I think I'm on him. I'm on him.
Wait a minute. Shrink 2. Yeah, shrink 2.
Alright, I feel kind of bad, but this guy's raidable now. I'm just gonna message him. GG's, bro. Alright, I'm not even gonna bother jump crony because it makes my desk go squeaky squeaky. How is he winning this, bro? Alright, hold up.
You have effects.
Hold on, a rage ability? Alright, just rage ability, don't know.
You have strength too. Rest 3, to be honest.
Rest 3 whenever you can. Just dead. Raidable. Got him.
GG.
Alright, I was not risking anything.
This kid is seriously about to come try to steal our raid. This sweaty bum
kid. Dude, tell him if he does it, he's dead. Bro.
He said you're gonna steal all the loot. Steal? It's no, our raid.
Or you're
I
dying.
Said it's our raid. Goof. Alright, go down that secret chest, boy. Mand you out. Oh, rogue set.
Alright, nice. Wait, he had potion counters.
Yeah, I got 2 of them.
I got 7.
Oh, nice.
Nice, bro. I don't know what that guy was doing. Alright, secret chests are somewhere in here. Oh, wait, no. This was his chest I saw, I'm pretty sure.
That was a secret chest.
No. I found it. Oh, my God. Wait, what? No, that's nothing good, but he had a secret chest with stuff in it, I guess.
Alright. What did you guys just do?
Medikit raidable.
I mean, let's see. Premium keys. Some blocks. Oh,
yeah. Easy loot.
Yep, rip raid.
I mean, bro, what? Oh, 16. Oh, 16 Patrox prepearls, dog.
Dude, let's go. I'm gonna have foam.
Alright, I'm out of base. So, right off the bat, I could tell this guy's got quite the interesting level 3 high. I can tell this guy's logging people. Oh, wait, this might be a trap, to be honest with you guys. Leaf trap right here, and it doesn't look like it goes around the base, so there's no way you could have a trap right here unless it's like really small. So just go ahead and let me enter the buddy. Okay, so I got strength 2. My aim just like botted out there, so I'm guessing it's gonna log on a faction member. I just usually will like a brick wall and then pearl into 1-by-1 with him. Obviously, that's always ideal. I should probably oh, what the fuck? Wait, what's he doing, bro? What's he doing? Oh, I had a bone right now. Oh, I should be so golden. Swear to God, boys. Wait, let me just... I could try to wait for him to, like, run back to his fence gates. Okay, once they get outside the base, you want to stay in the middle. You never want to go, like, ahead of them. You always want to stay in the middle of them and their fence gates, just so there's a higher chance that you could actually get them and, like, brick wall them outside the base like this. So, like, say I just went in front of him and just started being an idiot, then he'd probably get to his base pretty easily. So I can bambi web gun over here, cut out his feet for a bit. Let's just do this. Let's see, he's fucking panicking, dog. Wait, why would he do that? Why has he gone and done this? Oh, he's raidable. Okay, guys. I just made that guy raidable. Didn't look like he had the best loot on him, so I'm just gonna run straight over there. See if I can grab partner items just really quickly. Let's see. Nice, dude. Some potatoes. Very rich man. Let's see. This guy definitely has stuff from partner item malls, I'm guessing. Nope, good. No god pickaxe, fancy anti-redstones. Well, let's just take anything that we desperately need, which doesn't seem to really be anything. All right, I'll take, but yeah, that's what you want to do whenever you get people outside of their base. You always want to make sure that you're sticking like in between. You want to keep a good distance between their fence gate and them. Unless they get super far away, then you just want to stick on them and like get them to panic a lot. So that's what I do at least. And whenever you have two people, you always want to get one to just stick like right inside the fence gate, just like this, and then brick wall, like move back and forth and just like this. But yeah, so basically what I did there was I just stuck like right here while he was right here, just so if he did pearl back, I would have been able to just throw an easy pearl, get on the fence gate to brick wall him, which that's usually what you're going to want to do. So yeah, I'll bring this back.
Only if he tries to get into the full base, but I doubt. Okay. Bro? Bro? What are you doing? This guy's a madman. What is he doing, bro? He's just sitting here, like, ganking me out for no reason. That's bad. Am I have to pop a kid starter just so I can fucking get pressure plates and trap this guy? Okay, guys, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to bait this guy all the way back to the base, dude. Caleb, do you see this?
Yeah, like, dude, this kid's actually gonna chase you across the entire
place. Dude, is he really about to chase me back to my base? Oh, hey, what are these guys doing? Hey, bro. Oh, it's Nelk Films, I know that guy.
Wait, what the fuck? Why isn't it brewing?
Bro.
It's not brewing health helix.
Caleb, he's still chasing me, dude. Wait.
Hold on.
Wait, I actually need to have a fucking a second. Dog. Bro! Wait, just give me a second, bro. I can't. What? Why is this guy? He doesn't take knockback! Get me out of here, bro. You're crazy. This guy's going crazy, man. Okay, guys, what I'm gonna do right here. To be honest, I know this guy's gonna chase me into his my little faller trap right here. Guys, I know it. It's a such kit starter. Oh my god, guys, no way this works. Caleb, I think I'm about to get one with the trap, bro. Give me a second, guys. I got him.